I'm Stephen Holt. This is the Stephen Holt Show. And Jude, you just severed your hand.
No, barely.
Barely.
I said severed. Didn't
oh,
I? No, no.
You wanted sympathy, but you
I
have
only a bottle of water. You see, that's how tough I am. And the bottle of water won.
Oh, well, it's Canadian water. It's tough stuff. Well, you have all my sympathy. You certainly did in the movie of Anna Karenina, one of the best films of the year, one of the greatest performances of your career.
Oh.
Sir, I'm the Oscar messenger. Tom Hooper named me the Oscar messenger. I figure he knows what he's
talking
about.
That's a good man. He knows what he's talking about.
I think your performance as, now you have to pronounce the character's name because I don't want to
Alexei Karenin.
Alexei Karenin.
That's only two of four. I'm not going to mention the other four.
All right.
He's a Russian aristocrat. They've always got seven names.
You're like the poor husband of the glamorous Keira Knightley, Anna Karenina, who she's cheating on you. She's falling in love with somebody. She's married to Jude Law. How could she do this? I keep thinking of you as Dickie Greenfield and
Not anymore.
Or Hamlet. I saw your Hamlet.
Did you?
You was pretty dazzling. I had Peter Eyre on my show. He talked for like an hour.
Oh, I love Peter Eyre.
Yeah. Your father at the
Peter
Ghost.
Eyre was the only person I've ever met who's played Horatio, Hamlet, Claudius Polonius. Now he's played Hamlet's father, and he said his next role's to play Yorick the Skull. Which he said
I've done the state some service. He said he once directed a play of mine with Little Nell on the Fringe. It ran and ran.
So you know him well.
Yes.
He's a dear man.
Yes, he is. But so are you. We met during Sleuth. You were promoting.
But that
Sleuth.
Wasn't the first time we met, because that was only about 5 years ago. I'm sure we met here before.
I hope so.
Yeah, I think so. I think we did.
But it's just having to talk. Just talk about your character, which, I mean, you're almost unrecognizable. You like shave part of your
head. It's one of those
head.
Lovely joys of playing a part when it's a real challenge to really step up to something kind of new.
Jude, you were terrific. Just terrific.
You. Well, Joe, you know,
I loved Joe
created
loved
this universe.
Joe, yes.
And pulling off the necessary sort of role, the tone, if you like,
was
a real liberation for me, because there was an awful lot of rhythm and voluptuous sort of movement in this piece, and so I love the idea that this guy I play is emotionless, and still and kind of crippled with his introverted, cerebral, you know, like look at life.
It's a bureaucrat, and instead of being,
instead of being heartfelt or physical. And
very unusual.
Those kind of roles are wonderful to embrace. It was unusual, but you know, Joe's that kind of a director, and I'm always thrilled to be challenged in that way. When you're in good hands with someone like Joe, and when
did you ask him why did you think of me for this part?
No, I just said yes. I was just excited.
Joe Wright. Yes. Yeah.
Yeah. Exactly. And then on top of that, you know, this brilliant script and Kira
and Tom Stoppard's. You know, take on
extraordinary the extraordinary take. I mean, it was like he had actually had a conversation with Tolstoy.
You know, he did that huge long trilogy, which we had here.
Yeah, The Coast of Utopia.
Yes. So he's really versed in the Russians.
Yeah, he really is.
And I have to be Russian out of here far
That's
too
a good
soon.
Life.
Thank you, Jude. Lovely to see you. And I hope I see you at the Dolby Pavilion for the Oscars.
Oh, well, we'll
I think
see.
You're
Thank
be nominated
you for saying so.
Again. Well, if I say it, they have to do it.
Good.
Because if people don't talk to the Oscar...
Listen to him.
If they don't talk to the Oscar messenger, they don't win.
No.
It's true.
I love that. I love Tom Hooper should send you a brooch, actually.
Right, yeah,
Make
he
it
should.
Official in diamonds.
Right. Yes, he should.